Hey guys, and welcome to Turn Up with me, Missy Atkins.
And your boy, Mr. Alvin.
Not only are we checking out the launch of MTV Sugar's new series with our man, Toby King, we also welcome international Afrobeat artist, Falz the Bad Guy, to the studio.
So let's get straight into it and start the show. Hello, hello, and welcome to the show.
Coming up tonight, we join Eve as she checks out Don't Drop the Mic, an improvisation rap workshop in Nigeria.
And our Roman reporter, Toby King, joins us on the sofa to tell us about the launch of MTV Sugar's new series. Mm-hmm. But before all that, I am so excited to introduce one of the biggest Afrobeat artists on the planet right now. Ladies and gents, it's Falz the Bad Guy.
Hey guys, in the beginning, what's up?
Falz, it's incredible to have you here. Thank you for coming. Welcome to Turn Up.
Thank you for having me.
So you are in London. How are you enjoying London town?
London is nice, but it's cold. It's very cold.
It's cold.
Oh, the weather is chilly.
It's actually better than it was a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, people said there was snow.
No, this is bad for me. I'm coming from a very hot country.
True.
This is bad. This is bad enough for me.
So how long are you staying here for?
I'm around about 2 weeks or so. Cool. A big show coming up, and just shortly after that, I'll be going back home.
Okay. Yeah. So obviously, in regards to your show, you're performing at the O2 Academy in Islington.
Yep.
How important would you say your UK fans are to you?
Very, very important. I mean, usually when I go through my numbers with my guys, and you know, we check, we see there's a lot of response from the UK. Mm. So it's very important to come here and play a show for my people out here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So your name is Falz the Bad Guy.
Bad Guy.
Bad Guy.
Yeah,
baddest.
But I did some research on you, and I feel like it should be called Falz the Clever Guy, because you studied and read in uni, you got a law degree in Nigeria.
Yeah.
What happened? How did you go from law to music?
Well, the bad guy is a different kind of bad guy.
Okay.
So you have to note that it's spelled B-A-H-D.
Mm-hmm.
So it actually means something.
Mm-hmm.
It's Falz the Brilliant and Highly Distinct.
Uh-huh.
That's what
brilliant
it means.
And highly distinct.
You are getting me now.
Brilliant. Yeah. Coming from like a Nigerian background or African background, parents are very strict on what they want their children to do. You know, your father was a lawyer. How did he feel about you doing music? Was he disappointed? Was he happy for you?
People always ask me that, but... And I think also because both of my parents are lawyers and renowned lawyers.
Mm.
So it's like, you want to do music?
Yeah.
Coming from that sort of background. But funny enough, my parents have always been supportive, When I told them I wanted to do it professionally, they were like, all right. But I think that also is because at the time, I got my law degree already. So it's like, okay, you have that. So whatever you want to do with your life, go ahead. So for a long time, actually, I was living two lives.
Mm.
Yeah, after my degree, after I qualified as a lawyer, I was practicing. I was in active legal practice, and I was still doing music. So I was like a Clark Kent. I wear my suit, go to court in the afternoon. I love it.
Just like that.
So you spent a lot of time here in the UK.
Mm.
So how good is your British accent?
It's all right. I do try,
Yeah.
I'm not perfect, but I'm trying.
Not
what do you think?
That's better than me.
I'm doing all right.
I think you're doing all right. I really do.
I feel like you could pass as an Englishman.
Yeah, for real. Yeah. For real. Like, definitely.
And obviously, in 2017, during Christmas time, you had the Falz experience.
Mm.
That showed us two sides, your comedic side and your musician sides. How did that all come about?
Yeah, I was trying to do something different.
Mm.
Because, I feel like doing shows... it's all about showing your creativity. And a lot of artists might not really regard that. They may think, they just want to get on stage and, perform their songs as regular. But I wanted to give my people an experience and, hence the name, the Falz experience. I wanted, my fans to feel like it was much more than just a show, much more than just a concert. It was, so people that came felt like they were at a concert, felt like they were in the cinema, then felt like they were at a stage play.
Yeah.
So it was like everything all together, So it's mad.
So from that, what's more important to you, acting or music?
I can't pick.
Okay.
I really, really enjoy doing both.
Yeah.
But, maybe because I started out as a musician.
Yeah.
If I really had to pick, probably I'd say music, yeah.
That's it. So, and obviously, your very first like I would say, your very first main single that was out there was obviously Marry Me featuring Paul and Yemi Alade. How did things move forward for you after that?
Yeah, I think that would definitely be the single that brought me to prominence and sort of brought me to the limelight. Mm. And, you know, even though before then I'd put out quite a lot, that was actually my first album, you know, that song was on. So after that, I think, you know, everything just sort of...
Zooms.
Just sort of went fast, and it was surreal for me, but yeah, very, very interesting to experience.
Cool, and then so obviously, who's been like, you've collaborated with Yemi Alade, Paul, mm-hmm, Olamide, mm-hmm, Davido, who's been your favourite? Boy and a Boy, all of them, who's been your favourite?
You're setting me up. No, I can't, you know, I can't really pick one person.
If the okay, one.
If you had to, it's one. Important.
I cannot pick one, okay?
Okay, pick two. I'll give you two. Pick
I
two.
I cannot pick two. Look, I've worked with so many people.
Mm. Not even just Simi, like, you wouldn't just say Simi.
I've worked with so many.
Well, seeing as we're not going to get an answer out.
I've worked with so many artists, yeah, and you know, it's like,
different vibes.
Different vibes. Like, mm, if I'm in the studio with Simi, it's a different vibe. From Yemi Alade, Davido, Olamide, like, it's a different vibe. Mm. But, you know, like, for artists, I mean, I think a lot of artists will tell you this. At different points in time, you're feeling one song more than others, maybe.
Okay.
So right now, the jam that I'm feeling of mine is the one with Wandeko.
Okay, all right, that's good. Well, we are going to check out some of your music right now. So this is Jeje. Let us check it out. Disgusting. You be stinking. Got a bad guy singing. Baby, do me Jeje. I beg you, do me Jeje. Baby, do me Jeje. I beg you, do me Jeje. Baby, let me be your customer. Give me everything plus Jara. Say she want to give me gradually. You should give me all like a buyer. Baby, do me jelly. I beg you, do me jelly. You look like you think that's better than me, but actually, I think that's better.
Okay.
Well, Jeje is one of your many, many, many big tracks. And what would you say is the track that you're most proud of? Because obviously, you said you're feeling the one with Wandeko right now, but which is the track that you're most proud of?
Again, this is very difficult for me. Yeah. I can't really pick one and say this is the one that I'm proud of. All my tracks. It's like telling a parent, which one of your children are you most proud of?
True.
You know, I love all my children equally.
Equally.
Cool. And obviously, you've been doing music for 4 years, hence why I guess you can't pick a particular one. Have you seen your style change over time?
Definitely. There's been a growth. Mm. You know, it's... And it has to be like that for every artist, or else, you know, you're not really making progress. Mm. And, you know, with anything that you do, really, the more you do it, the better you get. So, you know, I feel like things are, you know, definitely changing. Style is evolving. Mm. And, you know, it's always nice.
Okay. Well, Falz, I've absolutely loved having you here.
Yeah, same here.
Yes, I really like your aura. Like the
thank you so much.
The vibe is good.
I did try my best.
You did, And because of that, like, you're not going anywhere. Yeah, you have to stay here for the rest of the show, so you're not allowed to leave. Yeah, you're still chilling. Yeah.
Make sure
he doesn't leave.
Yeah, he's meeting me somewhere.
So that's it. That's all we have for part one. But do not go anywhere. After the break, we chat to our boy Toby King and challenge Falz to the All About Me quiz.
Keep it locked. I got the love that song she sings so. I make a meter blow. Now my song she dey sing so. She never ever do. What we did nobody there. She dey like the one dress. She dey do the dirty dance. Valentino she dey wear, you know. She call me Funk Master Flex, you know. Everything I want she give me. She tell me every day she wanna see me, oh yeah. My farabale, baby, show yourself for your komole, 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 oh na 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 na, baby, make we dirty them, he dirty them. My farabale, baby, show yourself, dirty them, he dirty them, oh na 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 na. I know sabi anyhow way them they feel, but when I am with you, I'm feeling like a G. No sabi you to sabi anyhow way them they feel, but when I am with you, I'm feeling like a G. You too bad, oh my baby, yeah. Welcome back to Turn Up. And look who's on our so far. It's our Roman reporter, Toby King. Hey. Toby, what have you got in store for us today?
It's great to be back chilling with Falz, the bad guy. Yeah, so this week I went down to the MTV Sugar launch in London and I spoke exclusively to the stars of the show and found out why MTV Sugar's new series is the best one yet.
Jeez.
Okay, cool. Let us check it out.
Tonight I'm down at the Curzon Cinema to check out the brand new launch of MTV Sugar. This show tackles hard-hitting topics like HIV, mental health, and even complicated love issues. The show had broadcasted to more than 720 million viewers worldwide. So yeah, this is a big deal.
Toby has metamorphosized, you know, from basically a character that lost his virginity on the show, that was in season 3, to someone that is a bit of a Yoruba demon, as we might call them out, in season 6, you know. So basically, it's just a young boy that, you know, has changed in his behavior and in the way that he is just because a lot of things have happened to him in the past.
The new cast members, how was it sort of getting them involved and making them feel part of the family?
It was really easy, first of all, because obviously when I joined Sugar, I met people, I met Nick Mutuma, I met Emmanuel Kubweze and all those guys, and they made me feel like family. Sugar is a really big platform, right? So as a young actor, as a new actor, you probably might not really know what you're getting into. Like when they tell you, you think, oh, it's nice, you know, I'm going to be a part of Sugar, but there's a lot of responsibility that comes with being a part of a show like this that is really teaching at the end of the day, as well as entertaining.
Were you a big fan of the show before you got involved?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So when I got it, I was like, oh my gosh, yes, finally. Because I know that this show discovered Lupita Nyong'o, and I know the message is like, really, this is like one of the very few productions that actually passed a message that not only entertains but also informs and educates. So I was like, you know what, I have to. And Sugar is like worldwide, almost worldwide, if not worldwide, you know, a lot of people watch it, a lot of countries watch it, everywhere.
MTV Sugar is about love, life, sex, drama, fighting, but actually underneath this really good drama are some really important messages.
On this trip, I haven't actually gone out yet. I came in on Wednesday and I've been doing press and I've been doing PR and all of that good stuff. But I'm hoping that, you know, the fact that you've asked me, I'm hoping that maybe you have somewhere you want to take me tomorrow.
Hey, definitely. Hey. Look, you need to go Libertine. Have you heard of it?
Yo, I went there last time I was around and, you know, I regretted it because, you know, some sort of £4,000 was spent on the table. You know, because Anthony Joshua was right next to us and all of that. You know, it's a really nice place. London can be expensive, though. We know that for a fact. And for someone like me that's earning in Naira, you know, I had to change my Naira to pounds. Bro, it's like 500 Naira to £1. Crazy. And this season, we give you a 100% Naija experience, you know, from the streets to the slangs to the languages, you know, we kind of like give you a whole complete feel of Nigeria. That's number one.
It was so sick watching the newest season of MTV Sugar. If you're a fan, you're in for a massive surprise. If you're not a fan, then where have you been? This show is doing huge things for the West African community and for young people. So you need to watch it. That's Toby King for Turn Up.
Do you know what? I feel like MTV Sugar is so important. Like, it's an important show. They're covering heavy topics, as well as showing Nigeria and young people and all that kind of stuff. So, yeah, I think it's kind of sick. How was it for you meeting, obviously, all the guests and the actors?
Yeah, meeting the stars was too sick. Like, it's always different seeing them as actors on like, the TV, and then seeing them in person. Uh-huh. It's crazy.
Yeah, it's true.
What, Falz, do you watch Sugar?
Yeah, I've seen quite a few episodes. I don't follow every single thing, but I've seen quite a few episodes. And I like it. I think it's very educative and, you know, teaches very important things.
Yeah, 100%.
Definitely.
Yeah. Do you ever be in it?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I think you add a good, like, they should create a cool character for you.
Cool character.
Yeah. We don't.
Could be like someone's dad.
Or Toby.
How dare you? How dare you?
Well, Toby, it has been amazing having you on the sofa, like always. So please do not be a stranger.
Yeah.
Okay, so now it's time for us to join Eva Nigeria, where she's been checking out Don't Drop the Mic.
These sort of shows are lit. You're given a word, and then you have to freestyle rap around it. So let's check it out.
All right, DJ, drop it like it's hot. Now, do you actually believe that a bunch of random people can actually come up together and form original songs, from giving themes to words to events? Well, I'm a Bogobiri, Ikoyi, Lagos, Nigeria, and it don't drop the mic. Now, trust me, if you're somebody who loves to be spontaneous, please do not go anywhere. Stay tuned. It's your girl Eve, and it's Turn Up on Yanga TV.
So, the theme for tonight is outer space. So, the first obvious question for the night is, do aliens exist?
My name is Femi Aribisala. I work with Don't Drop the Mic. I'm the MC coordinator / part owner of Don't Drop the Mic.
All right, but really, what is Don't Drop the Mic about?
Okay, so we're a platform for exposure for people that express themselves, basically, and we're known for improvisation, which is basically getting a random topic from the audience and creating musicals, dramas on the spot.
Are these aliens? You are welcome to the world. All these aliens, you are welcome to this planet.
So what's your name?
Azubike,
how long have you been on the Don't Drop the Mic platform?
Oh, just about 2 months, actually. I'm new to the country, and then I found them maybe a couple weeks into being here, so I just followed up with them. Improvisation with music is something that I think is lacking out there. A lot of people, they have to go ahead and write what they want to say before they can say it. But improv makes your mind have to work. It makes you come up with something that you've already been thinking about, but you have to artistically filter out of yourself in a way that the audience will vibe with.
I'm going to give you a word, and you're going to give me something in 20 seconds. So the word is peace.
Peace.
Yeah, so go.
Okay. I let peace reign from anywhere. There's bodies dying and mothers crying with bodies laying in the streets. My brothers is dying, but we searching for peace. Two fingers up, but they only use one when they pull the trigger. That's the police. But you still continue to play, talking about you want to get paid. They look at you as a my son as a slave. So instead, look at yourself as a king and she's your queen. Then live your life supreme and let peace reign.
Oh, wow. That was really great. Thank you so much. Yeah, that was really nice. We've got talent here sitting down. I learned a lot. And the best part about it is the fact that they improvise. I mean, not everybody does that. Well, I had so much fun, and I hope you did too. Your girl Eve signing out. It's Turn Up on Yanga TV.
That actually looks so tough. Like, if you guys was to ask me to say peace, I'd be like, peace out. That's it. So seeing as I can't do it, I'm going to challenge you both, yeah? I'm going to give you a word, and I want you to freestyle a word. The word is, let's say, coconut.
Coconut?
Alvin,
that's such a random word.
Yeah, coconut.
That's a random
word. Your head looks like coconut. Let's go.
Wow. I like to drink from cocoa nuts. I need a bad girl with cocoa nuts. Bring me some dough or nuts. And I'm gonna have a cola nut. Hey, bang. Get me sick. Sick. Yeah, you're good at it. Not too bad.
Right?
I mean, no, that was mad. That was mad.
Sick in it?
You think you could
be
better?
That was mad. Do you think you
could
do better?
Pass on that lay. I'm not much of a freestyler.
Okay.
But I think that was amazing.
Thank you.
Yeah. I think you should sign me.
I think we should drop that as a record. Yeah, get in the studio, properly record it. I'll drop a verse on it, and then bang.
Coconuts.
Hey. Coconuts.
Hey. Need a girl with some coconuts.
Hey.
Drink with some coconuts. I have cola nuts. Hey, we're getting in the studio.
That's a jam, bro.
If we see you make a song. We are coming.
I'll give you credit.
I'm royalties. Yeah. Money.
You're arrested. Can't forget. Okay, that's it for this week. But before we go, it's game time.
So, Falz, we challenge you to the All About Me quiz. You have 60 seconds on the clock to answer as many questions as you can correctly.
Okay. I like games. Yeah. Let's go.
If you score more than 10 points, you win our turn-up trophy.
All right.
So, can I please get 60 seconds on the clock? All right.
Duh, duh.
Your time starts now. What does the bad guy acronym stand for?
Brilliant and highly distinct.
What color is your jacket, hoodie, and trousers in the music video for Laugh-It?
Black.
How many fans were at your concert for the Falz Experience?
5,000.
What was the name of your music group formed at your secondary school?
Schoolboys.
Which colors make up the Reading University coat of arms?
Red, white, black.
How many followers do you have on your Instagram?
2.9 million.
What was the name of your primary school?
St. Neil's Catholic Primary School.
What was the name of your character in Jennifer's show, Dive?
Shegun Shege.
What was your first official mixtape called?
Shakara the Mixtape.
Which year did you fully qualify as a lawyer?
2012.
What was the name of the clothing line you released in 2015?
Hello, bitch.
And last question, what was the name of the clothing line you released in 2015?
That's the same question, Hello, bitch.
What the no, so because Alvin read the same question twice, let's we'll give you one more. So right. How many views has Jeje had on your Vivo site?
1.5 million?
Okay, okay. We can confirm. Are you ready for the drum roll?
Let's get a drum roll.
10 points!
Oh! Can I give a speech?
Yes.
Honestly, big thank you to my fans. Everyone that supported me and really believed in me. I told you guys I was gonna do it.
That's absolutely been amazing.
Lit.
Thank you so much for joining us tonight. And a huge thanks to Falz for being here, taking the time out of your busy schedule to be here with us.
24.
It's 24.
Yeah,
can you feel it?
It's 24.
No, it's because you've been going to the gym.
Yeah, you can't feel it. It's weightless.
It's weightless. You've been pumping good weights.
It's a new kind of good.
Yeah, no.
How did you know? Well, until next time, guys. Peace out
and turn up.